opened in 1962, the Jester Lounge was Houston's first real folk club. Mance Lipscomb and Lightnin' Hopkins played there, as well as Guy Clark. The earliest recording of Townes Van Zandt at a commercial venue came in 1966 at the Jester Lounge. The Sand Mountain Coffee House was opened in 1965 by John Carrick and his mother at 1409 Richmond Avenue and quickly became the premier place to hear folk music in Houston. The Sand Mountain Coffee House was famously dry and despite this stayed open for over 10 years. It closed in 1977 and the spot where it once stood is now a parking lot. Liberty Hall opened in 1971 inside of an old church at 1610 Chenevert Street. Liberty Hall played host to any event that required a PA system and a stage. Lightnin' Hopkins, Bruce Springsteen, ZZ Top, The Ramones, The Velvet Underground, even Cheech and Chong were all on stage at Liberty Hall at one time or another. In 1973, it hosted the National Women's Political Caucus, and Gloria Steinem and Betty Friedan gave speeches. The venue closed in 1978 when the ownership group ran into financial problems. Where it once stood is now parking for the Toyota Center.
You don't want me. Why not tell me so? You won't be bothered with me.
Rex Bell opened the old quarter downtown at the intersection of Congress and Austin Streets in 1965. The venue gained national attention in 1973 when Townes Van Zandt recorded a live record there. That place shut down. Bell resurrected the old quarter in 1996 on Galveston Island. Since then, songwriters from Texas and abroad have been showcasing their talents on his stage. Rex Bell retired to Arkansas last year and sold the place. But as of this time, luckily the old quarter remains unchanged.
Dee 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 dee